It's sending a message without a protest. Mm.
That is the goal of a new food tour that is being organized here in the city. Stacey Delacat shows us how it's supporting immigrants one meal at a time.
Safari Restaurant on 116th Street in Harlem serves up Somali culture one steaming dish at a time. The restaurant draws a mix of locals and tourists who come for authentic Somali flavors. And this week, it will host a group called Breaking Bread NYC.
It's food diplomacy.
Jeff Orlick is part of a group of local food tour guides who came together after President Trump issued his executive order on immigration and refugees with the goal of spotlighting businesses owned by immigrants from the seven countries listed in the ban. The hope is to foster community and intercultural understanding over Syrian pastries and Somalian stews.
The best thing we could do is introduce people to these cultures just by eating. We know that if someone shares a plate, that's a great way of understanding.
Each week, Breaking Bread plans to release new food maps of restaurants from countries included in the ban. Their first event over the weekend drew 80 people to downtown Brooklyn for a tour of Yemeni and Syrian spots. This weekend, the group will hold tours in Bay Ridge and the Bronx and a dinner party here in Harlem.
I think that it's a great idea.
Safari restaurant owner and chef Shakib Farah, who came to the U.S. as a refugee himself 15 years ago and has family impacted by the ban, looks forward to hosting.
The contribution of Somali people here in New York or in America, it's a very positive way, and it should be seen that way.
Breaking Bread NYC originally planned to host events at immigrant-owned restaurants for the 90 days the travel restrictions were supposed to be in effect, but now with the ban in legal limbo, they say they'll continue to host them indefinitely. In Harlem, I'm Stacey Delacat, Fox 5 News.